we were talking about literature. What is literature? What is its utility? The purpose of this interaction during this lockdown period is to make you think. The purpose is not to take four definitions of four scholars, big names, and read it out to you. You can do that yourself. The purpose of this interaction is to kindle your thought process. The purpose is just to keep it at the conversation level so that you are involved. You just don't go anywhere. Students remain together because this is a difficult time, this lockdown period, and we have to be together, and internet is our ally. So we were talking about literature. Human mind is for the most part unconscious. Conscious part is a very small part of the whole structure of our mind. Most of our mind is unconscious, and there are several different, you know, different types of emotions. We don't think that we have violence within us. We don't think that we have revenge, jealousy, negative emotions, anger, wrath, positive emotions, love, affection, kindness, love for the country. So many things, you know. We have so much within us in the forms of different archetypes, which has been given to us through generations. Our forefathers, the primitive man, and then afterwards, they lived in caves. So in dreams, even today, we dream of a cave. We dream that we are moving somewhere in a cave. Those are the remnants of the primitive man within our genes, what we call in our country sanskar. That part remains within us. There is so much lying beneath the surface. What we see, the conscious mind, is just the tip of the iceberg. Now, all those pent up emotions need to be experienced, need to be expressed. And literature is one medium which makes us experience all those emotions. And that process is called catharsis. Our mind is cleaned. Of course, we cannot experience all emotions in actual life. We cannot do all things in actual life. So, through stories, through literature, we go through those processes and all our pent-up emotions come out. That is the reason why we like tragedies. Because people may ask you, why you like a tragedy? Do you like to weep? Do you like to cry? Yes. We all fear so many things. We fear death. We fear tragedy. We fear so many things, and all that fear, all that sorrow, all those emotions which are there within us come out through a tragedy. Therefore, after watching a tragedy, we feel light, we feel relaxed. That is the psychology of literature. Aristotle, even before Christ, you see, he could decipher, he could tell, he could discern, he could see, he could observe that humans are by nature observant. We cannot remain dumb. You put a human being somewhere and immediately she or he will start analyzing the situation. We want to make sense of things. We want to understand things. We want to explain things. And this basic human desire is expressed through literature. There are so many other purposes that literature fulfills. there are so many other roles which literature plays in our lives. We have to understand that the part of being human, the part of being a super soul, the part of being refined, part of being educated is filled by literature. Nothing else. That gap cannot be filled by anything else. Therefore, literature is necessary for life. Now, once we accept the place of literature in our life, let us ask the next question. The next question is, what are the types of literature? How words are constructed? Words are constructed in two manners, prose and poetry, gadya, padya, the two ways in which words are structured. Now, let us ask, what is poetry and what is prose and what is the difference between the two? When I ask a student, what is poetry? The general answer for the last three decades, you see, the first answer that I get is that poetry rhymes. Poetry is something which rhymes. So I tell that student immediately that there was a cat, she had a bat, she ate a rat, she was fat. It's rhyming. Is it poetry? No. It's not poetry. So rhyme alone is not the criteria of poetry. So what is poetry and what is prose? Before going into that, let me put a word of caution. In life, there is nothing like watertight compartments. And literature is a reflection of life. Therefore, in literature also, there are no watertight compartments. There is poetry, there is prose, but they are overlapping. More often than not, they are overlapping. So we can understand characteristics of poetry, we can understand characteristics of prose, but we have to realize that they overlap. There is poetic prose, there is prosaic poetry, and so on and so forth. Now, poetry. Poetry is something which follows rhythm. Poetry is something which reflects matters of heart. Poetry is something which appeals to your emotions. What is rhythm? Rhythm is a basic feature of life. The way our heart beats, the way we breathe, the way our pulse goes, this signifies the rhythm of life. Words, when they synchronize, words, when they resemble the natural rhythm of life, the flow of a river, the beats of a heart, the breath of a human being, when words echo the up and down, the rise and fall of natural rhythm of life. That is internal rhythm. I'm not going into complications, I'm not going into terms which are difficult to grasp. I just want to tell you what is rhythm. Rhythm is something which you can feel, internal rhythm. Poetry may be rhyming, it may be ending with rhyming words, it may not be ending with rhyming words, but it has rhythm. And in order to follow that rhythm, many times grammatical rules are put aside. It is not that poets don't know grammar, it is that they know grammar so well that they twist it, create their own language, create their own medium, idiom, their own grammar. So sometimes grammar is put aside to create poetry. Poetry relates to matters of heart. Poetry relates to matters of spirituality. Poetry relates to matters of soul. Poetry relates to elevated affairs. That is poetry. And prose, what is prose? Prose follows strict grammatical rules. There have to be proper sentences. And prose focuses on logic. Whatever belongs to the brain, whatever belongs to head, whatever belongs to rationality is reflected through prose. Now, as I told you earlier, you can say, you can give 100 examples, Hamlet's speech, Charles Lamb's Dream Children. Dream Children is poetry. It is written in prose, but it is sheer poetry. On the other hand, Dryden's poems, Pope's poems, even the poems of Poe, Edgar Allan Poe, they're so scary. Some of his poems are so scary. Dryden's poetry is called drawing room poetry. It is so prosaic. It discusses politics, poetry. So, as I told you earlier, there is always an overlapping of genres. Prose is sometimes poetry, poetry is sometimes prose, and it overlaps often. Just for our understanding, just for our comprehension, just for our analysis, we say that this is prose, this is poetry. Poetry is rhythmic, poetry relates to heart, poetry relates to rhythm, as I said, rhythm, and poetry sometimes puts aside grammar. Whereas prose relates to brain, it relates to logic, it follows a definite grammatical pattern. Thank you.